customizing the dock couldn't be any easier. As I mentioned before, you're able to increase and decrease the size of the dock just by hovering over this little divider line. You can click and hold and you can move the mouse up to increase the size or move the mouse down to decrease the size. Now I can do anything I want there. Now there's other hidden options. If we go into our system preferences right here, and I can go to the dock section, I can increase the size. Instead of using the little divider down here, I can actually come up here and move the slider to make it big or make it really small. Now, this is a good size right here. I don't have very many applications. This doesn't take up much room. But there's also a cool little section here called magnification. So if I check this box, if I hover, everything happens instantaneously. There's no need to log out or anything like that. Now, I can hover my mouse over the dock, and all the icons will get magnified, which is pretty cool. But that's a little too obtuse. Let's just lower the magnification a little bit. I like to have it right past the size of the dock, so it's not obstructive, but it's really cool looking. Now you can also position the dock if you don't like it on the bottom, for instance, and you want it on the left-hand side. You can actually push the little button, you can move it to the left-hand side. It keeps the magnification. You can still increase the size, make it bigger or larger, or you can do it on the right-hand side. And let's say you don't always like to see the dock, for instance. Let's make it a little bigger. You don't like to see the dock. You can automatically hide and show the dock just by checking this little box. Now I can move the mouse down to where the dock normally would be, and then there's your dock with all your same size and magnification settings. And notice when you click on an application, see how it bounces? You can actually turn that off just by unchecking this little box right here. No bouncing. Some people don't like that kind of stuff. So there you go. Customizing the dock in 10.5 couldn't be any easier.